has been an element of worship for the Sufi Muslims since the 13th century when it began in Turkey. Not quite the thing you'd expect to find in the middle of the Welsh valleys, but there is a community here. And here's what got the dervishes in a spin in the first place. Whirling is one of the tools used by Sufis, who are Islamic mystics, to come closer to Allah. It was started by the poet Rumi in the 13th century. The tall felt hats signify the tombstones of the dervishes' egos, the long white robes represent their souls, and the black cloaks represent the physical self. These cloaks are removed at the beginning of the ceremony to symbolize the leaving behind of worldly cares. Wales, home of the valleys, leeks, daffodils, and Sufi Muslims. Well, Iftikhar Ahmed and his family anyway. They moved here 4 years ago, leaving behind high-profile, high-pressure jobs in London to lead a life more fitting to their belief. They also spin around the country in a touring, whirling group called Forever Haqqani. So how, by spinning, do you communicate with God?
Everything in creation is spinning, mm-hmm. is actually whirling. So what you do is you just totally unite and surrender to nature. Mm-hmm. One of the most important things to actually do is to try and whirl with your spirit. Mm-hmm. If you whirl with your physical self, you will become dizzy, you will fall down. If you whirl with your spiritual self, then it's like the soul goes and the body follows.
Wow.
Okay.
Does it feel like it takes you into a trance-like state?
I personally get the feeling that everything around me is moving, but I'm standing still. Mm-hmm. Because you feel that there's something around you, almost like a hand, that's actually sort of just spinning you around.
Now, is it only Sufi Muslims who can whirl, or can anyone do it?
When we do our performances and when we do any of the workshops, no one has to be a Sufi, no one has to be a Muslim to actually whirl.
At the center of the whirling is the Sheikh, who communicates with Rumi, then the Prophet, then Allah. Sheikh Ahmed Dede is the Sheikh for Forever Haqqani. Now, when you whirl, one hand points up to the sky and the other down to the ground. What is the significance of that?
They are whirling, and it is in that time there is a light, whirling light comes. Whirling enters in the opening in the right hand palm, and it whirls around their heart and it goes out the left hand. And this whirling light is the light of divine love power. And if they whirl, they are receiving this and they are giving it.
Do you feel that whirling is still relevant in the 21st century?
Yes, it is still the best tools to open the divine love, especially in this time. We need it very much. If someone opens his heart pure, only to receive, that secret divine love will go and enter, like sugar cane. Mm-hmm. And if you enter in the cup of tea, the holy ocean, you need someone that he may say, I'm going to whirl you in my ocean. So you may melt, you may whirl, even for 7 steps. If it is a real connection, you will feel after 7 steps that something is really going to melt you in the ocean of love.
Downsizing from a glitzy London lifestyle to rural existence came as a bit of a culture shock to Iftikhar and his son Adam.
When I sort of came here, it was, I think, the first 2 weeks I spent sort of digging a bit of gardening and stuff, getting my hands dirty, and it felt like a real cleansing. I moved from sort of earning £50 an hour to working in a fish farm, which was paying me about £3.50 an hour. And it was a real realization of the sort of life that I was living and the life that I've chosen to live now, you know?
What about you, Adam? Must have been an eye-opener for you, I tell you. Yeah, leaving London, packing everything up and off to Wales.
That's right, I wasn't too keen on the sheep at first and the lifestyle, but I've gotten more used to it now.
How has whirling actually changed your life?
You know, it wasn't until I started the whirling that I found myself being able to stay in Wales more easily. I think I found a balance within myself, mm-hmm. and then I became more comfortable with my surroundings.
Because if you understand this...
It was time to see Iftikhar and Adam in action. People come from all over the country to these workshops to experience whirling for themselves. Sheikh Ahmed showed us the basic steps. Then it was open to anyone who wanted to get up and give it a whirl.
Look in your heart. Inhale, what you feel. Slowly, look.
I love music, I love dance, and it seemed to be very expressive of God's love and open to all.
It's just another way of expressing love and joy, like singing or painting. Yeah. It's just another art form that you can enjoy the love of God through.
So I've known for a while and I felt tempted to get up, but today was the first time that I really felt confident. The spirit was so strong in everybody today, it was such a communal thing that I just wanted to.
Love us and ask the divine love. Let the love.
Sufism has actually taught me to accept other people with a completely open heart. There is only one judge, and that's the Lord, whoever you call him. You call him Allah, you call him God, you call him Jehovah. It's made me more human. And I think, and I really feel, that's what we're here for. We're here to be human, and to be human, you have to accept other people.